ಪೌರತ್ವ ತಿದ್ದುಪಡಿ ಕಾಯ್ದೆಗೆ ವಿರೋಧ ವಿಚಾರವಾಗಿ ಸಿಎಎ ಮತ್ತು ಎನ್ಆರ್ಸಿ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಕ್ರೂರ ಕಾಯ್ದೆ ಎಂದು ಮಹಾತ್ಮ ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿ ಮೊಮ್ಮಗ ಹಾಗೂ ಈ ಪತ್ರಕರ್ತ ರಾಜಮೋಹನ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಅವರು ವ್ಯಾಖ್ಯಾನ ನೀಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. 1914ರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಹಾತ್ಮ ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿ ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಆಫ್ರಿಕಾದಲ್ಲಿಯೇ ಪೌರತ್ವ ನೋಂದಣಿ ವಿರೋಧಿಸಿ ಚಳವಳಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಅವನ ಜೀವನದುದ್ದಕ್ಕೂ ಪೌರತ್ವ ನೋಂದಣಿ ವಿರೋಧಿಸಿದ್ರು. ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಶದ ಜನ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಶದ ಪ್ರಜೆಗಳು ಎಂಬುದನ್ನು ಸಾಬೀತು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳಬೇಕೆಂಬುದು ಅತ್ಯಂತ ದುರದೃಷ್ಟಕರ. ಎನ್ಆರ್ಸಿ ಮತ್ತು ಸಿಎಎ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನಗತ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಮಾಡಿರುವ ಕಾಯ್ದೆ, ಈ ಕಾಯ್ದೆಯ ಅಗತ್ಯವೇ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ದೇಶದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಅನಗತ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಗೊಂದಲ ಮೂಡಿಸುವ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈ ಕಾಯ್ದೆ ವಿರೋಧಿಸಿ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತಿರುವ ಪ್ರತಿಭಟನೆಗಳು ಸಹಜವಾದದ್ದು. ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಪೌರತ್ವ ಸಿಗಬೇಕು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನೋಂದಣಿ ಮಾಡಿಸುವ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ತರಬೇಡಿ ಎಂದು ಮೈಸೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಜಮೋಹನ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಅವರು ಈ ಸಲಹೆಯನ್ನ ನೀಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
So, I want to mention that Mahatma Gandhi's first satyagraha in South Africa was against forced registration of Indian citizens, of Indian nationals in South Africa. So the idea of forcing people to register themselves in their own country is a very strange and a very undemocratic idea. And people should know that Gandhi's first satyagraha in South Africa was against the forced registration of Indian nationals in South Africa. So this idea is, apart from being undemocratic, it is also a cruel idea to ask people to prove that they or their parents are Indian nationals. Is something that no country does. And it was the white regime in South Africa that tried to force Indians to do this. That triggered Gandhi's whole Satyagraha movement. So, we should respect citizens, we should respect people who live in India. And if somebody is in India to do something wrong, the government should find out. But everybody should not be asked to prove that. Everybody should be assumed to be a loyal Indian resident and citizen. And the forced registration is a completely unacceptable measure.
Present situation, what's your opinion, sir?
My opinion is that there should be a good movement for democratic rights. There should be a united movement of all people for democratic rights, for equality, for mutual respect. That India does not belong to any one community, India belongs to everyone. So India should show to the world that equality and mutual respect and mutual friendship is possible. So that is should be our aim.
Necessity, CAB and NRC? Necessity?
Sorry? Is it necessary, sir? Is it necessary for India?
In India?
Not at all. No, in my opinion, absolutely not. Not only is it unnecessary, it is cruel.
Sir, you mentioned that supremacy in the state.
Yeah.
Please explain it, sir.
So I was saying that for a long time, until recently, the world accepted that equality of all, mutual respect for all, liberty of expression are the right values, democratic values. But in recent years, there is this upsurge of ethno-nationalism, that everybody in a country is not equal. Some people are more equal, are more, should be dominant, should be supreme. So in America, the white race should be supreme. So the African Americans, those who speak Spanish, those who come from other countries, they should not have the same rights. Similarly, in India, some people say that the Hindus should be supreme. But India belongs to all. America belongs to all. So this idea of supremacy, which is trying to push aside the idea of equality and of liberty, that idea we should resist.
But they are alleging that this is an election gimmick.
See, I don't. I have no secret access to the minds of these people. I can only say that what the policies they recommend are not neither wise nor helpful nor democratic.
Oh, great. Thank you so much.
Good luck.